Hi guys, my name is Shuli and welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be a Diwali look that I created using a palette that I will be reviewing in this video. I know this is a lot to catch up on. So this is the Diwali look that I came up with. This is really nice and warm, and also I added this smoky element so that it's appropriate for your nice Diwali parties and all. And also I'll be reviewing this product, which is the Swiss Beauty eyeshadow palette, in this video. So if you're interested, stay tuned for that. I would like to wish you all a very happy and prosperous Diwali. I hope this Diwali brings a lot of joy and a lot of light in your life, and whatever you have been wanting for or working for these past few weeks, months, or these years, I hope you get it. I hope all your dreams come true. I hope you get the fruit of all your hard work that you've put in. And have a happy and a safe Diwali. Also, please, it would be a request that you do not burn firecrackers, because it really hurts the ears of dogs and cats and other animals, and also the smoke and the pollution that it creates a lot of problems for birds and other insects, and we don't want to lose these animals. Yeah, we're already on the verge of losing a lot of like birds and animals. We should try and protect the ones that we have right now, at least. Firecrackers are not the essence of Diwali. Diwali is a festival of lights, and just light a few diyas and, you know, eat some sweets, have besan ke laddu, have kaju katli. That is what Diwali is all about. Meet your friends, celebrate with your friends, spend time with your friends and family, and give your dogos and cats some company so that they're not scared at all by whoever the dumb ass is, you know, lighting firecrackers outside. So yeah, have a safe Diwali, guys, and be responsible. That's all. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel and also hit the bell icon so that you're notified every time I upload a new video. And let's jump right in. We'll start off with the review first and then move on to the look, okay? So this is the eyeshadow palette that I was talking about. Okay, so this is what it is. Looks beautiful. The colors are stunning. Can you see? It's so warm. It's so beautiful. It has all matte shade and just one shimmery golden shade. I'll swatch that for you. It's a coppery gold color, which is very pigmented. I really like how pigmented these are. I have not used this palette yet before. I have just, you know, dug my fingers in to kind of see how it was, but I have not used it on my face per se. Today is going to be like a first impressions. The best thing about this palette is that it's really affordable. Like all of these palettes and all of the other products from Swiss Beauty are really affordable. Like I picked this up for between 200 and 250. I am not sure. I picked this up from Amazon. I'll link it down in the description box below. It's also available on Nykaa, but mostly they're sold out. So that is why I picked it up from Amazon. And Amazon, just one problem was it had really less options. But this is how it is. I think it's really stunning. And if you're like a makeup beginner and you just don't want to invest too much in like expensive eyeshadow palettes, I think going on with brands like these are really good, because you get to try your hands on different products and you get to practice better without like shelling out too much cash. And also, like, there's more room for experimentation, you get it? So let's start off with the look first. I'll quickly conceal my eyelids, like I'll quickly prime them and then I'll come back. So we're primed and we're ready to go. The only downside is it does not have a mirror like on it. But it's okay, man, you can't complain for 200 whatever bucks that it's come, that you also want a mirror. So much demand is not acceptable all the time. So I have not thought of what I'm going to do, but I'm just going to start off simple. I think I'm going to start off with this shade right here, this orangey reddy shade, and put it in like my crease first. I'm going to use this brush by Pro Art number 230E. It's like a nice fluffy blending brush, and I'm just going to dip it in. Can you see? It's so pigmented, like it did pick up a lot of product. Ooh, it's very pigmented. And you know what the best part is? I've seen matte shades being really chalky, like even if you dip in to like a Maybelline palette or something like that, Maybelline's eyeshadows are not that great. They're like not chalky but not pigmented at all. But other palettes that I've been to are really chalky, but this is not. This blends out really easily and it's also really pigmented. Like it's pure pigment. There's no talc or too much like you know, like powdery chalkiness to it. Like I really like how soft it is. It's a really nice eyeshadow, and for the price I think it's fabulous. I blended it out in the entire crease of my eye and now I'm just concentrating it on the outer third of my eye. Now I'll be dipping onto this orange shade right here. This is like really fiery and really bright orange. Can you see this one? So I'm just gonna use a smaller, more tapered blending brush. Okay, and this is ProArt and PF08 and my dog is also tuned onto it. But I'm just gonna dip into that. You can see again, this is really pigmented. I'm just gonna tap off the excess. I like this nice warm blended thing that we're going for here. I'm gonna take the same blending brush that we had used earlier and I'm gonna go into this lighter brown shade. Like I'm just gonna dip into it a little bit and just kind of blow out the eyeshadow that we had blended first. I'm gonna keep repeating it until I get a nice gradient of like orange, red and that lighter brown. I think this is perfect, like this is better. You can see there is shadow on my entire eyelid and it's like a nice gradient, like a very soft gradient of the colors that I chose from this. I think I'm gonna cut half my crease and then maybe use the shimmer shade on top. I'm gonna use like this angled brush and some concealer. Okay, so I have cut my crease, like it's not that great, but I cut my crease and I just lightly set it with like a little bit of foundation powder, not too much, like it's still kind of tacky. I did not 100% let it set. The reason I did that was so that the shimmer could, you know, stick to it better and give a more intense look. So now I'm gonna move on to the eyeshadow again and I'm gonna take like this, the shimmer, you see, and there it is. This is my half cut crease. It is a little more than half. This is like a 2/3 cut crease, if you can see. And it's not really neat, but it's there. Something. So, yep, I'll do the other eye and I'll be right back. So, I'm back with both my eyes done. Now, let's move on to the face and then we'll come back to the eyes and complete the rest of the look. So, let's start off with primer. Starting off with primer first, I'm going to be using the Color Bar primer and concentrating it more on my T-zone because this is like more of a dry season and it fell. My entire face does not get really oily, just my T-zone does still. Now there's that out of the way. I'm going to start off with foundation and I'm going to be using my favorite PAC HD liquid foundation in 3.7. This is my favorite winter foundation and I cannot do without this. I love how dewy and beautiful this is. So, yep. I'm not gonna do concealer, I'm just gonna use a foundation powder to set it so that there's like double the coverage. So this is a MAC Studio Fix in NC42. Now let's come back to the eyes and finish it off first. Not going to be using liner for this look, but I'm going to be using a kohl pencil. This is the Pack long lasting kohl pencil. This is right now my most favorite kohl pencil. Not right now, like I think in the past few years I've never liked kohl pencils, but this has been my absolute favorite. My everyday makeup game has changed because of this, and I'm gonna do an updated everyday makeup routine video for you so that you know how much I love this. So I'm gonna start off by lining my waterline, like my upper and lower waterline first, and then I'm gonna slightly overdraw my underline, like under my lower waterline, and then smudge it out using the smudger in this. So yeah. Once the lower line is smudged down nicely, I'm gonna smudge a little bit on top as well. Like, you have to line really close to your upper waterline so that you don't take up too much space, you know. Just a very tiny smoked out wing. Tiny smoked out liner, not tiny smoked out wing. I'm gonna dive back into the eyeshadow palette and finish the lower lash line. So I'm gonna go in this dark brown here first and kind of smoke out and set the kajal underneath. And now I've set both the upper and the lower liner with the dark brown shade. I'm gonna hop back into the orange one and I'm just gonna smoke it out a little bit to add the color and balance everything out, you know. I think that's that. I'm just gonna do the other eye and be right back. I used L'Oreal Volumilion lashes on both my upper and lower lash line. No lashes for me today because I'm just not in the mood. I also used the golden eyeshadow on the inner corners of my eyes. So that's that. Now I'm just gonna put some highlighter on my nose because I'm not gonna be highlighting my face today. So I'm gonna be using the Pack Baked Highlighter in 04. And just a little bit of this on the inner corner as well. To kind of balance the brightness. That's that. Now let's move on to the blush. I'm going to be using a balance of a matte blush and a baked blush. So for the matte blush, I'll be using Gingerly by MAC. This is like a nice earthy toned matte everyday blush. I'm just gonna coat my brush and I don't want to shift your focus anywhere from this particular color palette that's going on. So I'm not gonna use any contour or highlight today. This blush is also of a similar like color theme going on. Now I'd be using a baked blush. For that I'd be using the Wet n Wild baked blush in the shade Hummingbird Hype. This is like a limited edition baked blush by Wet n Wild. So this is what I'll be using. It's very shimmery. That is the reason I'll be skipping highlighter today. And yeah. You can see how nice and glowy this blush is. It's not appropriate to use like on a regular basis, but like if you want to glam up during the festive season or something, I think this is perfect. You don't even separately need a highlighter for this. I'm just gonna douse myself in it because I love the glow that it gives the skin, and it's not like a powdery chalky glow, it's more like a glow from within glow. So now comes the turn for the lips. So I'm gonna be using a mixture of two colors. This is Chili Nude by Maybelline and this is Madras Kapi by Nykaa. This is, I'm just gonna apply this first. If this goes well, then just this, otherwise this, to balance it out. It's a really beautiful warm orangey color. I knew this would be too much, so let's see. Rather than swiping it, I'm just gonna dab it to give it a more natural finish. And this is the completed Diwali look. I hope you guys enjoyed this look. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel and also hit the bell icon so that you're notified every time I upload a new video. And I'll see you in my next guy. Bye. Have a happy and very safe Diwali.